What's up, guys? Welcome back to Smart Trader. This is Dias Paul, and thank you so much for all your likes, comments, share, and all your love. And if you're a new viewer, then definitely anytime go to our channel, watch all the videos, and only if you're liking it, because this is just a quality type of subscriber. So only if you like this type of topics, then hit that subscribe button so that you can see my future videos. And for the ones who want additional services, you can always WhatsApp my customer care team to know what are the additional services, or else regarding my personal training or my videos. And for the ones who wants to open an account and be a part of my Telegram channel, you can click the link in the video description and open your account in Zerodha Ropstock so that you will be part of my secret Telegram channel. So in this particular video, we are going to talk about commodity trading finally. So you saw from 2 days, I was posting two or three days, I'm posting my live trading videos in commodity, especially crude oil mini. So yes, I'm not a pro, like I told you always in the videos. So I am in a stage of learning. So when it comes to equity, you know, I was good in equity trading. That's how I started YouTube. And after that, so if you ask equity, I would say 90-95% I'm confident on equity. Futures, I started later, like you know. So I'm around 70% confident. Just 30% improvement is required. That's what I'm working upon. But when it comes to commodity, I would say I would rate myself as 20%. Yes, I do trading commodity. I have done before. It's not that I don't have much experience, because it was not cup of my tea and I was not that much interested. But considering our channel is growing, now I'm planning to do commodity trading also. So I'm in the learning phase, 20% learning, right? So I'm in the learning phase. So the day I come to 60-70%, when I want you guys to grow along with me. So whatever I keep learning side by side, I will be sharing with you guys whatever I'm observing. Like, you know, I like observing. So whatever I'm observing also, I'll be posting. So you guys also can do those homeworks. And you can also learn, at least in a long term, we both will get better. So anyways, without wasting time, let's discuss what is commodity trading and how is it different from other types of trading. Commodity trading, the beginning. So we are going to start off with our basics for commodity trading. Okay, so a lot of beginners who don't even know anything about this commodity trading. So let's go step by step, baby steps, so that you also will be aware of it. So wherever you know, how much ever you know, you can pick up from there. People who don't even know can go from this video onwards. All right, so this is going to be the beginning. So a lot of people are scared, what is this commodity trading and how is it different from our equity trading? So I'll just give a comparison with our equity so that you get to know at least what is the major difference with these two, so that you can take a trade, whether you need to be scared or not. All that I will just tell you before taking your decisions. All right, so now first of all, what is this commodity trading? Just like how we do our equity trading, we do company stocks, like for example Reliance company, or let's say Wipro company. So we trade on these company names, that is your equity shares. But in terms of commodity, we are trading on commodity, that is gold. What is commodity? Gold, zinc, let's say copper, okay, oil, that is your crude oil and all that. So like this, all the commodity products we are trading on them. So that's called your commodity trading. Now these have a wide scope compared to the timing. Now let's go one by one. Okay, so this is the timings which I found, the latest timing which I found on the articles whichever I saw. So this is the latest timings which I've got. Okay, so whenever you're seeing the video, this is recorded on this particular day. In the future, if it changes, be mindful, go and check on Google with the latest dates and time. So for agricultural commodities, it says around 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. But whereas all the bullion metals, that is gold metals, crude oil, which I used to do my live trading, if you're not seen, all those you will be trading from 10 a.m. to 11:30 p.m. Look at the difference, guys, from morning till night. Okay, so much of time frame is there. That is the reason if you see morning, the volume is very less and later the pickup comes up, right? So you can check the chart of any, you can search crude oil, okay, crude oil, or you can search gold, zinc, silver, and check the graph, okay. Only for trading, you need to activate on your Zerodha or whichever trading account you should activate. My Zerodha is not yet activated on commodity, only Upstock has it. So if you are not activated, but you can still see the charts. So you can go and search the products and check zinc, silver, gold, or crude oil and see the graph. So majorly morning, the volume will be little less. Later on, it will pick up, because after trading equity, that is 3:30, when people are done, they will automatically enter into commodity. And also, a lot of people tell me they don't have time to trade morning equity because I have office, Indian timings. I come back home at 6 p.m. So you have the time to trade at commodity. So if you don't have time to trade in equity, slowly you can learn commodity and start commodity
trading. So basically we may trade in these ones only, so you have time till 11:30. So this is the timing difference. You know equity by now around 9 to 3:30 is our timing. This one is 10 to 11:30, so we have an advantage here. Now talking about the ownership, just showing a difference between our normal equity, how we used to do, and commodity. What is the ownership? In equity, when we buy a share, what happens? You are becoming the owner of the share, all right? Shareholder, you are owner of that company. Of, if you're having one share owner, or 100 share owner. But in terms of commodity, you are buying lot size type, okay? Like just like a futures trading, how you do in equity futures, okay? Same way in commodity, we do future types, like future of crude oil, future of gold, like that. Okay, and you are not a owner. So that concept is not like this in this case, okay, in commodity. So only in equity, we say we are owner, I'm holding all the shares. In commodity, no, because we have an expiry. Here you can hold it for lifetime, right? Lifetime you can hold if you're buying in cash. But here you use margin, okay? Margin you use for intraday, or else you can hold for 1 month, just like expiry. And what is the expiry? Last Thursday. Okay, last Thursday is the expiry of this commodity, but in this case, you know, there is no expiry because it is a lifetime. Till the company is there, you can hold the shares. You can't hold the shares within the expiry time, it will get squared off. So that is in terms of ownership. Now talking about the volatility, you know, equity would have seen the market going up from green, suddenly it goes to red, right? That in terms of volatility, comparatively to commodity, this is lesser. Commodity is very much higher. If you see at 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, the graph will be going like this, sudden fall will be like this. Okay. So be very careful. The stock will be, the commodity will be going like this, crude oil, suddenly it will fall like this. It will be going down like this, suddenly it will recover like this. The volatility is very, very higher. So the risk is also going to be very higher. Okay, in this case, so be very careful. The volatility is higher compared to your equity. So keep mindful. That's the reason I tell you, practice first, learn first. And when you're after learning, like how I'm doing, just go with one lot or two lot. Okay, don't test with 10 lots, 20 lots and all that. Go with one lot and practice till you become good at it. The last one I would say, risk. Yes, the risk is higher. Like I told you, here the margin are higher. We're doing all the buying all the commodities on a margin basis. Okay, so you buy on one lot, two lot minimum, like that. So you don't pay full amount, okay, most of the time. So you trade on a higher and you get higher leverage, okay, higher leverage compared to the equity what you're trading, right? You know, in futures the leverage is higher, right? In terms of equity future also, same way here the leverage is higher compared to your regular equity. So the higher the leverage, and the leverage is first of all higher, plus the volatility is higher. Imagine by the time it come halfway only, your 100% capital is gone, right? So the risk is higher in case of commodity, and equity is better. That's the reason beginners should start off with equity slowly, then go with equity futures, then slowly you can enter if you want commodity. Later if you want, you can touch options and all those, but go one by one, baby steps. So these are the differences, what I would say majorly in terms of equity and commodity trading. So if you have not seen my live trading video, the basic ones which I have done for you guys, you can see how I am putting my orders. Okay, so it is not much different from your futures. Okay, stock futures how we do, it is not much different. You're buying one lot or two lots. Okay, the price of the commodity will be there, your target again you will calculate. And brokerage, you can use Zerodha brokerage calculator to know how much brokerage will go, so how much minimum target you need to achieve. All that information you can see on each stock. And I would say the liquidity in equity is better, okay, as soon as you buy, as soon as you sell, it will be very quick. But not in commodity, okay. Certain commodities will be very slow, it will not move at all. So some, it will take a lot of time if you see the graph, because from morning 10 to night 11:30, you know, people won't be trading exactly same, right? So the volume will increase once, as and when you go in the evening part. I would say rough 5 o'clock, 5 p.m. after that, the volume will increase. So a lot of people trade after that time, and that's why you see a big spike or down spikes happening. So be very mindful, take baby steps when you practice. So do paper trading, okay? Now we have told you the basic differences, and I've told you the just for the beginners, I've just told you the meaning and all that. This is just our beginning. So step by step videos I will do. Also watch my live trade videos, whatever I posted today morning also, that is afternoon. So watch that video also just to get an idea that what is that crude oil, what is that, how it is different from equity. Everything is same, just that how you handle it, how you pick it, how you enter, your strategy will change. All right, but your discipline should be same how you do it equity. So let's start off our journey like this with the beginning. This is a beginning story. We'll go with part 1, part 2, part 3 like that, like a movie series we can do on commodity, step by step learning. In equity, I was too quick in coming up with ideas. All right, so commodity, I'm going to start off. So in my learning journey, I also want you to start in the start off so that you also come along with me. All right, so thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, then hit that like button and share this with all your friends, and hit that subscribe button and support our channel. See you soon in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.